Dear colleagues, I would like to present for you some results of our research about the classification of fractal time series. The world around us is fractal and random. Fractals are objects that save their structure at scaling. Fractal random processes save their distribution law at the time scaling. Many time series of complex technical and natural systems have fractal properties. These are medical and biological signals, financial series, seismic signals, telecommunication traffics. And in these areas, we have tasks of classification fractal time series. But the classification of time series by machine learning is a new area, and most of studies do not take into account fractal properties of time series. The objective of our work is to carry out a classification of fractal time series by machine learning. In our case, time series are realization of multifractional Brownian motion, which are divided into classes according to their fractal properties. Classification methods are Bagging, random forests, and neural networks. Our input data are fractal time series. A random process is self-similar if it saves its distribution laws when scratching or compression in time. Self-similar properties are characterized by one parameter, one number, Hurst exponent. Multifractional processes are non-homogeneous fractal processes, and multifractal properties are characterized by a function generalized Hurst exponent. One of the well-known models of the multifractal process is multifractional Brownian motion. It was proposed by Benoit Mandelbrot as model of financial time series. To simulate a realization of multifractional Brownian motion, we have used a combination of two fractal processes: binomial stochastic multiplicative cascade and fractional Brownian motion. Modeling method allows us to get model time series with given multifractal characteristic. Important task of time series classification is selection of features. In our case, we used statistical, fractal, and recurrence characteristic. Fractal features are the sum values of generalized Hurst exponent. Recurrence characteristic are new features in machine learning. They show the proximity of series points in phase space. Classification methods. The decision tree method is effective, well-known effective method of classification. But decision tree models are unstable, and most often ensembles of models are used. In our research, Bagging and random forest with classification and regression trees were applied. During the experiments, different neural networks were investigated, and two ones were selected. The first neural network is a fully connected perceptron with regularization lays. The second network contains recurrent lays to take into account the relations between elements. For both neural networks, the ADAM stochastic optimization algorithm was used. In the experiment, model time series of multifractional Brownian motion were generated. We had 10 classes with different ranges of Hurst exponent. For each time series, the Hurst exponent was chosen randomly inside the given class, given range. Statistical, fractal, and recurrence characteristics for every time series were calculated and were inputs to classify it. The cumulative realization of multifractional Brown motion and the realization of increments were classified by separate experiment. Table 1 and 2 show the average probabilities of correct class determination for every methods for cumulative realization and realization of increments. And we can see that classification of increments realization showed more better results. In general case, the best practice was the Begin with regression trees and recurrent neural networks. In conclusion, I want to say that the classification on model time series of multifractional Brownian motion has shown good results. We understood that it is better to classify the series of increments. The next step in this direction will be the classification of real-time series with fractal properties from various data sets. Thank you for your attention.